vacuum. I don't know if it's got a notch on or not. Put that little example on it right there. So we know where the front is. Now we take the rings off. These have three sets of rings, just like most engines. This one actually has oil cooling. Those tiny holes right there, oil cooling holes, which is pretty cool. Things like that make it last a long time. Just about to grab this thing.
Supposed to do that?
Not ideally, but if you're replacing it, it doesn't matter because it might be how you can get an edge on it. You gotta try to get behind it, pull it out. Maybe. There we go. Oh yeah, that was a rough shape. It was seized up. Not have been good if we tried to run it like that. We would have broke, torn the whole motor up. All right, so two more.
What about this top part?
We'll clean that off. That's the dome. It's the side that sees all the explosions. There we go. Little part. There we go. That broke. This is what was rusted up into the motor. The compression ring, because that one was in charge of feeling all the explosion. Top ring, middle ring, some gap there. Scratch the piston. Thank you. Rub it in between the ends of the piston ring. We can force it apart. Really tap it so I don't damage the piston ring or the piston. Broken piston, now we clean it. Broken piston ring, sorry. No, I don't know if it's hot because it's windy. Oh, I put one there. Mechanically clean it. So this is a thin little wheel that gets down in there. That's got to be on there. Actually, I don't want that. The back is fogged up, can you see? Okay, now that's cleaned up.